This little baby that is sitting on my left is an Ashe Mirakuhove, favor. Indeed, she is a miracle, people of God. Last month, on the 29th of June, I left home. I went to the hospital just for normal checkups, monthly normal checkups for my baby. When we got to the hospital, the nurse who was in charge just took my baby. She asked me what was the problem. I said, she's okay. She just came for checkup. Then she said, your baby's eyes are too yellow. And I was like, too yellow? There's been too yellow since birth. Then she said, there's a problem, ma'am. And I said, what problem? Then she took my baby. She put the baby on the bed. She started checking at the baby, holding her tummy, opening her eyes, but the baby was crying. In fact, going back, Bichana, when I gave birth to this baby, she had discovered she had jaundice at 2 weeks. When I'm saying jaundice, I mean, oh mama, you know the baby will be having yellow eyes or having yellow pool. So I discovered it when she was 2 weeks. I went back to the clinic, I told the nurses, they said just breastfeed her too much and put her on the sun a bit. That's what I did. When I went back the third week, they just said, it's okay, just continue breastfeeding. I did this, people of God, for 8 months. Now she's 9 months. Then until last month when I was when I went there for checkup, the sister who was there, she said, this is now severe jaundice. And I was like, severe jaundice? What is severe jaundice? And then the nurse took the baby. She started saying, do you have money on you? I said, what money? She said, there are tests that are supposed to be done on your baby that are called LFTs. But we don't do them here. You go to a private hospital. I said, how much is it? And then she said, you have to have something like $160, $170. And then I was like, okay, I will go from here. I didn't have money. The intention that I had was, if I go back home, I'll just continue breastfeeding. I won't go for the LFTs. So when I went, when I was about to be there, when they were about to release me, the sister in charge said, this lady, she won't go with this baby. Mama, we are admitting you. I was like, you can't admit me. I left some other kids at home. She was like, so the other kids are important than this one. I was like, no. I will go for the test. Then she said, we are admitting you. I was admitted on the 29th of June. And then on the 29th of June, I stayed for almost 4 days in hospital. The same day I was admitted, I called one of the protocol ladies here. I told her, I'm admitted in hospital. They are saying my baby is not feeling well. Could you please help me with prayers? Because I'm trying the evangelist prayers. They were not reachable. Then she said, it is well, mama. And then from there, I was in hospital 4 days. The fifth day, the doctor came. The doctor said, you are going to Blawayo, mama. I was like, Blawayo, is this so serious? You know the doctor's language. When they talk as doctors, sometimes they don't understand. Then they said, you should go for a scan before you go to Blawayo. I went for a scan. But the way the man who was doing the scan was looking at me, I knew something was wrong. He gave me the results. I went to the hospital. The doctor called me the following day. He said, mama, your baby has got a disease called biliary stenosis. And I was like, what is biliary stenosis? Then he said, there is a blockage in the tummy of your baby. And it's like some of the tubes are swollen. So lapho okumele kuhambe khona like ibhayo into the bowel lapho emele khona ayifiki. So ikungo circulate one place. So the baby has to go to Blawayo, their specialist clinic. I cried, people of God. And I said, what is happening? My baby is almost crawling now. So what is happening? She was normal, she was almost crawling, she could sit. I began to see the devil at work now. And I said, okay. Some ladies from the church came. Oh, God, they encouraged me. They said, don't worry. It is well. God is with you. Just go, my daughter. I was like, amen. My sister came there to the hospital with my two girls here, all my twins. They bought me living water. They put sand inside. They made it sand inside. They said, Mama, just continue ministering the water until you get to Blawayo. Don't worry. I went to Blawayo that same night. When I go to Blawayo, things began to be so tense, people of God. I began to see that my baby was really sick. She began to cry continuously, And the doctors would come in numbers, maybe 10 or 8. They would gather at the bed, they would chase me out, I would go outside. They would start holding the baby, doing a lot of tests there. I would hear my baby cry and I didn't know what was wrong. When I tried to ask the doctors, what is wrong? They would say, don't worry, Mama, just keep praying. People of God, I never prayed. From the day I went to Blueo, I never prayed. The only thing I could do, I would just cry. Then the doctor in Blawayo said, your daughter has got no blood. We want to add blood before you go. We are transferring you to Harare. So before you go to Harare, the baby, we have to do something on the baby before you go to Harare. People of God, I was torn apart. The only thing I could do, I could hold my baby and cry. The moment I would cry, she would stop crying. She would look at me and I would stop crying. When we went to Harare, before we went, they said, we are organizing an ambulance for you. We are going to Harare. When we went to Harare, we went with an ambulance. When we go to Harare, it took almost 6 days. They didn't do anything. What they were doing, they said there are 6 surgeons here. We have got kids specialists here. Then I was asking them, what exactly is the problem? And you know the doctors. They didn't tell me, they were speaking riddles. Don't worry, Mama, everything will be fine. Until the senior surgeon came. When the senior surgeon came, I was holding the sticker that is written here of my testimonies. When I was holding the sticker, the doctor said, Tisha, Mama, Bata, Mama. And I had broken my wristband and I put it on her arm. Then they said, do you believe in these things? I said, yes. They said, I'm a rabbi. And then I, in my heart, I just said, it's only you, God, who knows. I stayed 5 days in Harare, so almost half a month now. Inside the hospital, the 6th day, they came for their rounds again. They looked at my baby. They said, Mama, we need to take you for counseling before we tell you what we are going to do on your baby. I felt the world coming down on me, people of God. They gave me counseling. They said, the truth, we have to tell you the truth today, Mama. I was like, tell me the truth. They said, we have got 3 options what we are going to do on your baby. We would rather, Mama, you go back to Victoria Falls and just stay with the baby until God says, it's my time. Or you would rather we give your baby an injection called vitamin K and she would live on that vitamin. The vitamin cost $30 for what you have 3 times. But they said it will only last here for 2 years. So in 2 years in Agwana, I just have to let her go. Or I go for an operation. But the operation was 90% death and 10% to live. People of God, I didn't know what to do. I just ran out of the hospital. I left the doctors inside there. One of the nurses came after me. When she came, she said, Mama, where are you going? I said, you people want to kill my baby. Just kill him. They said, you won't kill your baby. But instead, Mama, just calm down. My parents were already there. A lot of people had traveled, some had left before they'd come. They'd come there. They were now asking me about if I have a funeral policy. That way, how will I carry my baby from Harare to Big Falls? You know, even my parents, they were now putting money together. My relatives from the UK were sending money. That way, my baby passes away. I know I got money to start from somewhere. I said to the doctor, the only thing you can do, open my baby. They said, are you ready to open? I said, open her. They said, tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock, you are going to theater. but just be ready, Mama, she won't make it. The following morning, we went to the theater. 8 o'clock, I was in the theater. They said, take her off her clothes. I took off the clothes. When they took off the clothes, they said, you can now go. I was like, but she's still crying. They said, no, she will sleep. Then I left the theater. People of God, she went into theater at 8:15. 11, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4. I was in the waiting room. 5, 6, 7, people of God, just in the waiting room. I was stressed, people of God. The operation that they did on her was called conjugal on table. The operation, as you can hear the name, you will vula umtwana and take out everything. It was like an experiment, amen. They took the baby to the theater, she went to the theater. Wavula, if you saw songe razalwan from Lapetkasela Kuna Napa, Spigamutine Napa. They opened the baby, it was almost past 8. I called my father, I said, my baby is no more. My father said, why are you saying your baby is no more? And I said, all these hours, they are in theater. Umono to watch and have a puma slows and the goddess Katilos out. The hamba, Wakuama Rapa, the hand. Uwana behamba, kungela mzo kuluma nani. 30 minutes, 8:15, I had a call. The doctor said, my Anashe, I was like, yes, doctor. They said, come, run. Come to the ICU. I went to the ICU. Just the moment I got into the ICU, people were called. My baby opened her eyes.
Hallelujah! Celebrate Jesus! Celebrate Jesus!
How serious the operation was before I got my test, my advice. They discovered that she had a cyst inside her tummy. The cyst had lived for 8 months. So they cut off the cyst, then the balloon is amathumbu, and half of her liver was already damaged. So they removed the liver, and when they cut off the liver, I thank the men of God, people of God. When the Papa called me when I was in hospital, I told Papa the situation. He just said, take this phone, go and put it inside your baby's tummy. I went and put it inside your tummy in the blanket. People of God, things just changed. My baby is back to life. Last week on Sunday, I came to church. Papa blessed me again with the living water. And I've been using it. People of God, I thank the God of prophet in the mighty name of Jesus. My advice to you is, when my baby was admitted there, people of God, I never prayed. I never said a word to God. The only thing I could say was, God, you know what is inside my heart. You know what I want for my baby. Just take care of it. Today I am holding my miracle baby in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah!